Please refrain from flash photography as it distracts our actors. Restrooms are located outside of the theater in the hallway. If you should need to leave during the show, please use the exit in the rear of the auditorium. Also, GTMS is a smoke-free zone. Thank you for not smoking. There will be one 10-minute intermission. Now sit back and enjoy our production of Into the Woods.
More than anything the world was. Greens, greens, and nothing but greens. Parsley, peppers, cabbages, and celery, asparagus, and watercress, and filipers, and lettuce. He said, all right, but it wasn't quite. Cause I caught him and they got into my bed one night. He was robbing me, harassing me, rooting through my rooting finger, bending my umbrella, and ripping up my red pin, my teddy, and my brain box. Too late to spell him. Right there, he turned him into stone, or a dog, or a chair. But I let him have the red pin, I'd love to spare. In return, however, I spare a spare. He can let me have the baby that your wife will bear. And we'll call it a square.
I had a brother?
No, but you had a sister.
But the witch refused to talk with any more of his sister. Not even that her name was Rapunzel.
I thought I had been more than reasonable. But how was I to know what your father had also hidden in his pocket?
What?
Beans! Beans? The special beans! I let him go, I didn't know he'd stolen my beans. I was watching him roll back over the wall, and then bang, crash, and a lightning flash. Well, that's another story, never mind. Anyway, it was a big day hit, and it made my day.
Now, into the woods to sell the cows.
twice. Not to my liking.
Hello, Jack. How did you know my name?
How much are you asking for the animal?
Oh, no, less than 5 pounds.
Sir? 5 pounds! 5 pounds! Why do you think I can exchange her for a sack of beans? Come along, Milky White.
There are spirits here.
Good luck, baby.
If you know what you want, let it go, and you find it and you get it whole. Do we want to talk or not? And you give, and you take, and you bid, and you bargain, or you live to regret.
Will you please go home?
There are rights and wrongs and in between. No one waits when fortune intervenes, and maybe there is a little magic. Who knows?
Go home. I will carry this out in my own fashion.
And so the baker continued his search for the cake as red as blood. As for Rapunzel, the witch was careful not to lose this beauty to the outside world, and so she shut her within a doorless tower that lay deep within the forest. And when the old enchantress paid a visit, she called forth,
Rapunzel!
Thank you. sunlight drew me close, and he swallowed me down, down the dark, slimy path, where lay secrets that I never want to know. But I know things now, many valuable things that I hadn't known before. Do not put your faith in a cape and a hood. They will not protect you the way that they should. And take extra care with strangers, even flowers have their dangers, though scary is exciting. Nice. Different than good. Now I know, don't be scared, Crane is right, just be prepared. It's a nice, noble life. And a little bit not. Mr. Baker, you saved our lives. Here.
Are you certain?
Yes. Maybe Granny will make me another with the skins of that wolf.
Thank you.
Aunt Silva Baker, the second article in hand, feeling braver and more satisfied than you ever felt before, ran back through the woods. And as for lad Jack.
Only a soul would exchange a task for beans.
Know those beans would grow into an enormous stalk that would stretch into the heavens.
Show you just how small you are. supplies for a year, and a new chimney, and a thatched roof.
But could you buy yourself a child?
Who are you?
How badly do you want a child? 5 gold pieces, 10, 20?
I hadn't thought to put a price on it.
Exactly. The money's not worth it. When the boy is good, you should be granted.
Hey, come back here. Give me that pot.
What are you doing here now?
I see you're in a cave.
Yes, I have the cave. Only 2 items left to locate.
3, 2.
I have the cave and the cow.
Give the cave.
What have you done with the cow?
She ran away. I never reached home. I've been looking for her all night.
I should have known that then to entrust her to you.
She might have just as easily have run from you.
But she didn't. I'm sorry I lost the cow. I should have yelled. Now please, go back to the village. I will make things right. And then we can go about our lives. No more hunting in the woods for strange objects. No more witches and village boys and hungry little girls. Go.
For her. Beautiful one I danced the evening with.
Where did she go?
The spear.
I too found a lovely lady. She lives on the top of a tall tower within a door of stairs.
And how do you manage to visit?
I called her Rapunzel, Rapunzel. But then her hair to me. She wears the longest, most beautiful head of hair, the yellowest corn, as which I climbed to her.
Rapunzel? Rapunzel? What kind of name is that? You jest.
She's as true as your maid. A maid under for prince? That it sense? None would work from us.
Yet one has. Did I abuse her or show her disdain? Why does she run from me? If I should lose her, how shall I regain the heart she has won from me?
What are you doing?
I'm here to make amends.
Okay.
Oh, Providence, my milky
cow.
And what do you propose I use to purchase this cow?
Here, tell Miss Magic.
No person with a brain larger than this looks fit a cow for a thing.
Then resign yourself to a childless life.
I feel it is best for you to go for the cow, as I have made in these previous youths with a golden slipper, and I think I might succeed in winning one of her shoes.
Fine! That is simply fine!
Unfortunately for Rapunzel.
No!
The witch discovered her affection for the prince before he feared her away.
Why didn't you tell me you had a visitor?
The wall made it from that tower.
I gave you protection, and yet you disobeyed me.
I'm no longer a child. I wish to see the world.
Don't you know what's out there in the world?
Well, he cares. This is more than just
exchange for it.
She's milking!
I don't understand!
No, it doesn't matter. Oh! So
that night where the beats had been stolen and the light had flashed, was now returned to her former state of youth and beauty.
In no way, after a night of severe indigestion, was reunited with the now wealthy Jack.
As to Rapunzel, she lived impoverished in the desert until the day her friends, wandering aimlessly, heard a voice so familiar that he went towards it. As he approached, Rapunzel, overjoyed at seeing him, fell into his arms, weeping. Two of her tears split in his eyes, and the touch restored his vision.
I will go and come fetch you as soon as you learned your lesson.
Mother?
This is where I truly am. Come with me, child. We can be happy as we once were.
She will not go with you.
Let her speak for herself. But you're the only feeling I know. Come with me. Please. You give me no choice.
Thank you.
this production together. This first set of flowers are for the woman that always makes us go forth to our best, not just the first grade level, but to the really eighth grade level and seventh grade level we can be. She's the one that says, do you want us to do the mommy version or the director version? And the mommy version is, you're wonderful. But the director version is, you need to work on this to make it better. And that is the woman that makes us all do better. And these flowers are for Mrs. Yamaguchi.
Charlie Brown, and yours truly is playing Charlie Brown.